a Subway. First opening up shop as Pete's Super Submarines in 1965, Subway has grown to be the largest fast food chain in the world with over 44,000 locations and 110,000 employees. Subway has grown so large there are two separate locations within walking distance of my house. Subway was first founded by nuclear physicist Peter Buck and college student Fred DeLuca. They opened up Pete's Super Submarines to pay for Fred DeLuca's tuition. He was going to school to be a doctor.
Ironically, he was worth a total of $3.5 billion from Subway alone at the time of his death in 2015. Also, another side note, I didn't realize that subs are short for submarine sandwiches until this project.
They first opened up in Bridgeport, Connecticut and sold 365 sandwiches the very first day they opened. It's pretty good if you ask me. The Subway sandwich name was used for the first time in 1968. By 1974, Peter Buck and Fred DeLuca owned and operated over 16 different Subways. The famous BMT, which stands for Brooklyn-Manhattan Transit, was first introduced in 1975. The 6-inch sub, or the snack sandwich as it was called at the time, was first introduced in 1977. By 1982, there were over 300 different Subway locations. In 1984, Subway expanded overseas, and then in 1986, they expanded into Canada. Also in 1986, club sandwiches and party platters were introduced. Subway aired its first commercial in 1991. This was the start of a long line of advertisings, product placement, sponsorships, promotions, and controversy. This first commercial is nothing really special. It's just some guy talking about how cheap and cool Subway sandwiches are. And I mean, they're not wrong.
Hashtag not sponsored.
Later that same year, Subway was featured in Terminator 2 Judgment Day and promoted the film through the limited edition Thirst Terminator drink.
Also pretty randomly, in 1995, Subway sponsored an Indy racer. Yeah, that means that this car is sitting around somewhere, and I want it.
Starting on January 1st, 2000, a new line of Subway commercials were introduced. These commercials featured everyone's favorite sandwich guy, for the time being, Jared Fogel. Jared served as Subway spokesperson from 2000 to 2015. In that time, Jared appeared in over 300 commercials, the NBC sitcom Community, Sharknado, and SNL.
He was also parodied on South Park.
Jared earned his notoriety within Subway by losing over 245 pounds eating nothing but Subway sandwiches.
He actually donated a pair of his jeans to a museum. This is an actual thing that happened.
Anyways, with his presence, Subway revenue tripled. And while he was mostly loved as the spokesperson, he had an unfortunate downfall. In 2007, the FBI began investigating Jared Fogel for numerous sex crimes. For 8 of his unbelievably successful years, he was being investigated. In 2015, the FBI finally had what they needed and arrested Jared for paying for sex with minors and child pornography. Not cool, Jared. He was promptly fired from Subway and taken to court, where he pleaded guilty on all charges. He was convicted for 15 years in federal prison. You might think it ends there. But no, it goes deeper. In 2004, Jared began the Jared Foundation. This organization was dedicated to raising awareness about childhood obesity. Sounds noble, right? But the director of that organization was also arrested in 2015. Russell Taylor was charged with child exploitation, child pornography, and voyeurism. While in jail awaiting trial, Taylor actually attempted suicide. He was then promptly charged with 27 years in federal prison.
And yet, it goes deeper.
It was then found out that the Jared Foundation had not issued any money or grants to any of the people it was supposed to. The organization itself actually dissolved in 2012 when it failed to pay the $5 annual fee. Now instead of eating delicious Subway, Jared spends the rest of his days as a convicted sex offender.
Donde? Esta la biblioteca. Me llamo T-Bone, la araña discoteca.
On a lighter note, Subway did make a big appearance in the third season of Community. In 1992, Subway began to open up locations in different schools' cafeterias. In order to parody this, Subway opened up shop in Greendale Community College's cafeteria, the main setting in Community. However, due to Greendale bylaws, 51% of any business opened up on campus must be owned by a student. To get around this, Subway enrolls a corpo humanoid at Greendale.
I don't recall seeing Subway in my premenopausal post-feminist experiential marketing class.
Actually, I'm on the wait list for the pre-men post-fem X mark.
Who are you?
Gang, meet Greendale's newest student, Subway.
Your name is Subway.
Yep. Using a groundbreaking but surprisingly legal process known as corpohumanization, real people such as myself are now allowed to represent the collective humanity of business owners. I have contractually waived my birth identity and am now a man and student named Subway.
I don't believe this.
Subway made another appearance in Community during its fifth season when it nearly bought out Greendale Community College in order to open up its own sandwich college.
$5 foot long.
During Jared's time at Subway, their most famous promotion began. The $5 foot long promotion began in 2008 and was met with overwhelmingly positive response. While it was supposed to be a temporary promotion, a permanent $5 foot long menu was instated soon after. This menu featured a range of different sandwiches that rotated out differently each month. Sadly, this promotion came to an end when all footlongs were set to be $6 in 2016.
But then it returned in 2018, only to be discontinued later that year.
Eat fresh.